Sibbald's Fife and Kinross. Quote, "Myself have agreed to try whether I can master and kill this spermaceti whale, for I could never hear of any of that sort that was killed by any man, such as his fierceness and swiftness." Richard Strafford's Letter from the Bermudas, Philosophical Transactions, A.D. 1668. Quote, "Whales in the sea god's voice obey." N.E. Primer. Quote, "We saw also abundance of large whales, there being more in those southern seas, as I may say, by 100 to 1, than we have had to the northward of us." Captain Cowley's Voyage Round the Globe, A.D. 1729. Quote, "And the breath of a whale is frequently attended with such an insupportable smell as to bring on a disorder of the brain." Ulloa's South America. Quote, "To 50 chosen sylphs of special note, we trust the important charge, the petticoat. Oft we have known that sevenfold fence to fail, though stuffed with hoops and armed with ribs of whale." Rape of the Lock. Quote, "If we compare land animals in respect to magnitude with those that take up their abode in the deep, we shall find that they will appear contemptible in the comparison. The whale is doubtless the largest animal in creation." Goldsmith, Natural History. Quote, "If you should write a fable for little fishes, you would make them speak like great whales." Goldsmith to Johnson. Quote, "In the afternoon we saw what was supposed to be a rock, but it was found to be a dead whale, which some Asiatics had killed and were then towing ashore. They seemed to endeavor to conceal themselves behind the whale in order to avoid being seen by us." Cook's Voyages.